Hello, welcome to Outward, and this is a Chakram build, but it's a more special one. As you can see, you have to use the Mage Stand to sleep for the mana reduction, just because of the new mana reduction system, more or less the new one. I'm using the Jade Lich set. You can use the Gold Lich set, but that will mean you have 5% extra more mana reduction, but sadly the physical resistance is not as good and you also get a buff to your decay damage if you use it like this. So this is how your damage looks like. But for example, if you just use a dark varnish on your weapon and a possess potion, just look at how much decay damage you can do. So this is mostly for PvE, not for boss fights. I mean, you can just kill a lot of people or minions like this, but again, this is mostly like a damage build. Yeah. And besides, if you even go higher than that, let's use a cool potion and of course a warrior elixir. So at this point you can basically, how much is that, 50, 80, almost 90 damage, and you get 25 extra damage, 25% extra damage to the frost and the physical when you attack once. So this means you can do over 100 damage on your second attack on an enemy. Yeah. And yeah. The chakram is most like a secondary thing. Either way, let's just buff up our frost, because you can also use the infused frost for your cool. In case you don't want to use more varnishes. Let's apply the cool potion again. Venice, I really like this build because you have so many stats. For example, health and mana and stamina. This is a lot of stats. So for this one I just have the bear questline, but I choose the ancestor memories. You of course have the blood giant, buff the peacemaker elixir, and also the spell blades awakening. And of course the warrior monk for the master of motion buff. So your stats should be looking something like this. Yeah, I'm only using frost because I want to do more of the elemental discharge. Besides, you're fighting horrors here, so they are resistant to the decay damage, but if you just fight something else, use the decay damage because it's a lot better. And of course we can use... Oh, I missed my puncture. A small little note about the elemental discharge. So this does 60 damage and 60 impact damage. So this means I do 60 frost damage and 60 impact damage. But if you use the infused wind, it will actually change the elemental discharge to be 140 impact damage and 30 ethereal damage. Also, as a small note, you can also find, let's see, that's a dead body over there. You can also use the reveal soul. Okay, let's use up some mana. You can also use the reveal soul. And summon your minion. Because a minion is always helpful. And you can also use the spark spell in order to regain some mana. What is that spark spell? So if you use spark spell right now, you will actually regain some mana. But you don't really need that, so let's conjure. By the way, the Ley Line passive will also give you a lot of mana. 0.15. So yeah, adding all of these things together, this makes the build very, very good. You only need a few health potions and some buffs, of course. But not many. Okay, where is it? Where is he? Okay, here he is. Okay, let's use what? He knocked me down just because we don't have any impact resistance. Come on, go down, big guy. Ah, pretty good, I would say. Stop that. He killed my minion just because of how strong his fire attack is. Also, I have a lot of antidotes with me this time. So if you just did a croissant, some Sergio Sefiche for your mana regeneration and some marshmallow tartine, you'll basically be fine. Just look at the mana regeneration. But of course your mana will be burned if you use it, so eh. Do you have a soul on you? No, you don't. Rest in peace. So now we have to find another dead body, right? Eh, not really, because the build is strong enough to kill the horrors pretty fast. I wish I had some bandages on me. Okay, let's do that again. By the way, don't forget you need the discipline buff for those. And yeah, let's use an ice varnish, why not? It does the same damage either way, so you can just use this one. If you don't want to buff with the cool potion and then with the infuse frost and then again with the other one. So remember, this has a huge range, so you can just slow him down like that. And kite him if you really want to prolong the fight. But he's pretty fast and he'll catch up to you. So do something like that, and then the pierce one. But remember, this is very close range. Then just run away a bit until your skills are not on cooldown anymore. And that's about it. See, very easy build to use, and having so much health and so much resistance will actually be extremely good. Now, do you have a soul, Mr. Skeleton? Because I want to try to kill the boss and show you why the build is not really good at that. Of course, you can kill the boss even with this build. What do you mean? His soul already left his body. I'll try to kill the boss, but I don't really like it because you have no resistance, you have no staying power. Hey, don't do that. And this also might happen, so remember, check your abilities. Run away, don't stay and fight them. Remember, you are on cooldown. He may get a few hits in, but you can just kill him very easy. So again, that's one of the hardest monsters in the game, and you can just kill him by stepping backwards a little bit and waiting for some of your skills to come back. And also with the mana regeneration from the Chevichet and the health regeneration, you can basically go around and kill everything. Now I'm just looking for another corpse, because I want a little minion before I go fight the big boss. You know what, forget it. I don't know where another corpse is and I'm tired. Okay, let's go and fight the big boss. Oh, this should be plenty of fun. Let's use some speed buffing. Ah, this should be enough. Of course, we'll use the Mist Potion and the Resistance Potion, the Ethereal, the Ether.
Oh, that's a bit fishy, eh? How they didn't know where we were going?
Oh, I hate Twitch so much. Why do they stop the... Okay. I was watching something on Twitch and I closed the stream, but he hosted someone or something like that. Okay, I was buffing, right? Let's drink one more of that. Only a few buffs, nothing too major. Again, the elemental resistance potion is almost a must-have when you're fighting the monsters that are called the bosses. Okay, here we go. Keep your fingers crossed. Again, the buff is a little unstable because you don't have a lot of staying power. I mean, you have a lot of health and that will help you definitely. But if you get knocked down and you get comboed, that's the end. Easy, easy. Okay, let's run away a bit because this is like a phase fight. You have to do as much damage as possible to him and then retreat. Yeah, but cold damage is not exactly the best damage against him either. So let's switch to physical. Let's see how this does better for us. Yeah, this is a little better. And as I said, infuse wind for all that impact damage. And now let's cheese him a bit. So he's down for the count. And you also want pain all the time on him. Knock him down, drink your potion. Okay, this is going pretty well. Do your damage. Wow, this is actually going much better than I expected. Okay, knock you. This is not good. My buffs will soon run out. As you can see, he will destroy your armor because this armor is not really meant to be sustainable in combat. Did I miss him? Wait a minute, what was that? That was not supposed to happen. Yeah, that was some kind of a bug. Anyway, I pressed something else. Okay, well, let's take that hit. Okay, let's run away from him now. Oh! Very weird, I pressed the tab key to lock onto him. So yeah, this boss... What? He just cancelled my attack. That's brutal, man. They are so fast, that's another problem. Yeah, to be honest, this is not exactly how you kill him, but again, this just shows you some of the problem of the game. Because right there I just lock onto him, and because I locked onto him I couldn't avoid his beam attack. And then I was just running straight to him because I couldn't go another direction. But they're definitely possible to be killed with the chakram build. You just have to, you know, dance a little around them and make your phases, I mean attack with all your skills. Then wait a little bit, then knock them down with the elemental discharge with your infused wind. Well, too bad I didn't get to kill him, but you saw how it can be done. And it was quite a fun build. Again, some people say I'm bad at the game or things like that, but the bosses just need a lot more practice with the build, and I don't really have the time to invest 1 hour into fighting him with the chakram build. Either way, I think on my second attempt I could kill him with this one. But either way, that's food for thought. But you can try it and tell me the results. Wait a minute, I still need to do something, I mean... I don't have that. I just need something for the, you know, the thumbnail. Because I'm too stubborn to make a casual thumbnail and I need each one to be different. Just look at that, it's destroying my leg. Hey, I want to be in the sun. Come on, game. Okay, this is perfect. See you next time. Bye.